Praise the Lord. Good morning, viewers. You are welcome to another powerful and a great section of Command Your Money. I'm your popular host, Pastor Tokwe Oluwayemiwo, the regional overseer of the Mountain of Fire, East African Kenya region. God bless you as you listen in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. This morning, we're going to be treating a very special topic. And I want you to stay tuned as you listen to the word of God that is going to transform your life. This morning in Jesus' name. So this morning's message is titled, Anointing Breaks the Yoke. Anointing breaks the yoke. What is the meaning of the anointing? Praise the Lord. What is the meaning of the anointing? Anointing in the Greek Bible world means charisma, which means endowment. I pray this morning that you shall be endowed by God. You are going to receive a charisma that will break your yoke today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. That is the meaning of the anointing. And when you go to the book of Luke chapter 4, verse 18, it talks about how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. Praise the Lord. Amen. I pray that God will anoint you today. He will transform your life. He will change your story in the mighty name of Jesus. What is the meaning of yoke? Yoke in Hebrew, Bible tells us, ole. That means O-L-E. The Greek Bible calls yokes as zugo. These two words means to enslave. These two words, ole and zugo, they mean to enslave. That is to bring into bondage. That is to restrict somebody. I pray by the anointing that is coming upon your life this morning, everything that enslaves your life, anything that brings you into bondage, anything that restricts your life, by the anointing, they shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. So what is another definition for the yoke? The yoke means oppressive restriction. What is another definition for yoke? It is a terrible and a bad thing that makes life difficult to somebody. What makes life difficult, that bad thing that makes life difficult for you is a yoke. Praise the Lord. And I pray for you today, by the anointing that came upon Jesus, that breaks yoke, that breaks you, we break your yoke today in Jesus' name. Let's quickly go to the book of Luke chapter 4 as we proceed. Luke chapter 4, we're going to read verse 18. Luke chapter 4, verse 18. That's the anointing that came upon Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Spirit of the Lord, Luke chapter 4, verse 18. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon me because he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captive, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable years of the Lord. Hallelujah. It is when the anointing comes upon Jesus that he was able to save those people who are under severe yoke of the enemy. Now let's quickly go under the definition of what is a yoke. Let's see what the Bible tells us here in Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, it says, and it shall come to pass in that day. I pray for you, that day is today. That day is this morning. And it shall come to pass, Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, and it shall come to pass in that day that his body shall be taken away from thy shoulder and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Praise God. There's only one thing that can destroy yokes in your life. It is the anointing. And I pray for you today, as you are waking up, God is going to anoint you to destroy your yoke. And it is today. According to what the word of God says, and it shall come to pass in that day, and that day is today, that the anointing will destroy your yokes in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Let us look for another definition of yoke. Yoke is an emblem or a symbol of subjection. Praise the Lord. Yoke is an emblem or symbol of subjection. What is another definition for yoke? Yoke could be spiritual. It is an oppressive restriction, oppressive power. Today, God is going to set you free in Jesus' name. Yoke is the one that dictates how far a person can go in life. Praise God. Today, it shall be broken in your life. Yoke shall be broken by the anointing in Jesus' name. A yoke is a wooden cross piece that is fastened over the necks of two animals and attached to the plow or cart that make them to pull. Praise the Lord. Is that wooden cross that is fastened over the necks of two animals? Praise the Lord. That restrict their movement. That do not make them to be fast in their journey. Today, anything that is stopping your speed, any yoke that is stopping your speed shall be destroyed today in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, you are going to be free from satanic yoke in the name of Jesus. What is another definition of a yoke? A yoke is an electromagnet assemblage around the neck of animals. Praise God. Today, you'll be free in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Now, I want to discuss this morning on the types of yoke that we have. We have different types of yoke that we need to destroy by the anointing. We need to destroy by the anointing. So I'll be mentioning those yoke now, and you will be able to identify your own yoke and destroy it by the anointing. Number one types of yoke that we have is what we call the heavy yoke. I pray for my viewers that are listening to me today that are under a severe heavy yoke. That yoke shall be broken by the anointing this morning in the name of Jesus. 1 Kings chapter 12 verse 4. 1 Kings chapter 12 verse 4. It says, "Thy father made our yoke grievous now. Therefore, thou the grievous service of thy father, and his heavy yoke which he put on us, lighter, and we shall serve you." Hallelujah. They were talking to this man of God that there is an heavy yoke on them. I pray today, anyone that is under a perpetual heavy yoke, by the anointing, that heavy yoke in your life shall be destroyed. So there can be an heavy yoke that restricts you. So when you are dealing with heavy yoke, you need every prayer to deal with every yoke. So that an heavy anointing that will break and destroy the yoke. Praise the Lord. They were asking him that, "Please, this yoke is too heavy on us. We cannot carry it. Lighten it for us." So there's an heavy yoke. That's the first type. That is the first category of yoke. Today, God will destroy every yoke in the name, every yoke in your life in Jesus' name. Number two is also where we read in the same chapter. It talks about the grievous yoke. Because a heavy yoke is a teaching whereby a heavy yoke can sink a destiny. When there's too much heavy yoke, you see the destiny of that person sink. But a grievous yoke is the one that causes pain. Praise the Lord. It causes pain in the life of people. Grievous. Praise the Lord. Because of his heavy nature. Hallelujah. I pray today. It's also the same 1 Kings chapter 12. Hallelujah. That says, "Thy father made our yoke grievous. And now, therefore, make thou thy grievous service of thy father and his heavy yoke." You see, grievous yoke and heavy yoke, they work hand in hand. When you are going through an heavy yoke, you will pass through a grievous yoke. Today, every grievous yoke that is causing pain in your life shall be destroyed in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Number three types of yoke that the anointing is going to destroy today is what we call the iron-like yoke. Yoke like iron. It needs a lot of prayer. Let's quickly turn our Bible to the book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 48. Heavy yoke, praise the Lord. Iron-like yoke, praise Jesus. Deuteronomy 28, verse 48 has this to say. "Therefore shall thou serve thy enemy which the Lord has sent against thee, in hunger and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want, and in all things. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee." I pray every iron-like yoke that is assigned to destroy you, you will destroy them now by the anointing in Jesus' name. Look at it. When you are going through an iron-like yoke, you'll be serving your enemies. Hallelujah. You serve them in hunger and in thirsty and in nakedness. Praise the Lord. Because the Bible talks here, and it shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. I pray for anyone that is going through an iron-like yoke. You are serving your enemy in hunger. You are serving them in thirst. You are serving them in nakedness. Today, that iron-like yoke shall be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Then there's another type of yoke. It is called the wooden-like iron. The four categories of yoke is called what? The wooden-like iron. The iron-like one is made of iron. The one wood-like iron is made of wood. Today, any form of yoke that is in your life, I pray in the name of Jesus, you shall be set free from them in Jesus' name. Let's quickly go to the book of Jeremiah 28, verse 13. Jeremiah 28, verse 13. I pray for everyone that is listening to my voice, that is watching me right now, in the name of Jesus, every wood-like yoke in your life shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Jeremiah 28, verse 13. Jeremiah 28, verse 13 has this to say. Praise the Lord. Go and tell Ananias, saying, thus says the Lord, thou hast broken the yoke of wood, but thou shalt make for them yoke of iron. Can you see the relationship? Praise the Lord. Go and tell Ananias, saying, thus says the Lord, thou hast broken the yoke of wood, but thou shall make for them yoke of iron. Praise the Lord. For thus said the Lord, verse 14, of hosts, the God of Israel, I have put a yoke of iron upon the neck of this nation, that they may serve Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, and they shall serve him, and I have given him the beast of the field also. Praise God. So that is for you to know that iron-like yoke is stronger than the wood-like yoke. God said they have removed the iron-like yoke and the wood-like yoke, and he's putting an iron-like yoke. Today, any form of yoke that is in your life today, it shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. What is another category of yokes? The yoke of hatred. When you just discover that people just hate you for no reason, it's a yoke. You need to destroy it today by the anointing. Number six, disfavor yoke. When you need to get favor in a place, you are not getting favor, you work tirelessly. Instead of you to be favored, you are getting disfavor. It's the yoke of disfavor. Number seven is the yoke of oppression. Praise God. And I pray today, God will set you free from every yoke of oppression in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. The yoke of oppression. In Isaiah chapter 54, verse 13 to 14, and all the children shall be taught of the Lord. The grace shall be the peace of the children. In verse 14 of Isaiah 54, verse 14, in righteousness shall thou be established. Thou shalt be far from oppression, for thou shalt not fear from terror, for it shall not come near thee. Praise the Lord. So the Bible is telling us about a yoke here called the yoke of oppression. I pray by the anointing in your life that breaks the yoke of oppression. Oppression yoke shall be far from thee in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. So the Bible is trying to explain to us the yoke of oppression. Eighth category of yokes is in the book of Psalm 91, verse 6. Hallelujah. The yoke of death. Every yoke of death in your life today is thereby destroyed in the name of Jesus. That's what the Bible tells us in the book of Psalm 118, verse 7. Say, you will not die, but live and proclaim the goodness of the Lord. The Lord knows that there is a yoke called the yoke of death. And in the book of Psalm 91, verse 6, talks about the pestilences, and talks about the wasters at noonday. The power that keep people at a prime age. So today is a yoke. When you see people dying at their prime age, it's a yoke. Today, that yoke shall be destroyed in your life in Jesus' mighty name. The next yoke is the yoke of slavery. The yoke of slavery. Maybe the enemy has put a yoke. You are serving. You have never become a master. all the days that you have lived on earth, you have become slaves. Hallelujah. Praise God. You have become a perpetual slave. It's a yoke. You need to break it. Hallelujah. Then another yoke is the yoke of poverty. When you invest money in business, in millions, and you have nothing to show for it, your life is poor. You don't have money. You don't have wealth. It's a yoke of poverty. Praise the Lord. That was what the devil introduced to the life of Job. Job, that was very rich in cattle, rich in everything. He was one of the richest men in the East. But after some time, he lost everything. He became poor. He lost everything. It was a yoke. And the wife told him, go and deny God. Praise the Lord. Because of the yoke of poverty that was placed upon him. I pray for you today, by the anointing, every yoke of poverty is destroying your life in Jesus' name. The yoke of failure. Another category is the yoke of failure. You see some people, they have gone to school. I've seen somebody who did not even attempt examination. They still send him result, fail. That is a yoke of failure. No matter how they reach, no matter how they try in life, they will always fail in life. It's a yoke. No matter how hardworking, no matter how creativity they are, when the yoke of failure is in your life, that person is meant to fail. Until the yoke of failure is destroyed by the anointing. Praise the Lord. The yoke of demotion is the next one. Yoke of demotion. When your colleagues are supposed to be going up, when you're supposed to go higher, you bring yourself down. The yoke brings you down. It brings people down. The yoke of demotion. Praise the Lord. Look at your age mates. Some of your age mates had gone far. Some of your age mates are at the top. Some of your age mates are high flyers. Praise the Lord. They are story makers. Hallelujah. But where are you today? The yoke of demotion has brought you down. Praise the Lord. I perceive that the yoke of demotion was in the life of Samson. And that yoke brought him down. Somebody that has been up all of a sudden came down. Praise the Lord. It was the yoke of demotion. I pray for you today. Every yoke of demotion working against you in your office, working against you in your career, today that yoke of demotion is broken and destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Then the yoke of evil covenants. There are some covenants our forefathers have made, or there are some covenants that you yourself you have entered into. We call it unpaid vow. I was counseling a young lady one day, and he told me, Pastor, the man I was to marry told me to put a blade on my skin. That is satanic. And for me to lick the blood that comes out of the skin with the blade and make a covenant that she will marry the man. But the lady said she knew in herself that she's not going to marry her. She just took the blood covenant and drank it. And after some minutes, he threw it away. And she never married the woman, the man. And now today, the man is saying, you have made covenant with me. It is an unpaid vow. It has become a yoke in the life of that sister. Until the anointing breaks that yoke. So I don't know the kind of covenant, conscious covenant, unconscious covenant, inherited covenants that your parents have entered into demonic world that is affecting you. It is a yoke. Today, the Lord will break that yoke in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So there are yokes of evil covenants, of unpaid vows, and the yoke of shame. I can't forget the story of a young lady on the day that she was going to do an introduction to the family of the husband-to-be, the fiancé. Right there, because there was a yoke of shame in her life that she has not broken. Do you know what happened? She fell and started rolling. She has what is called epilepsy, and she started vomiting saliva and rolling on the ground. And the whole family member said, oh, is this the person you are going to marry? That was the end of the introduction, the yoke of shame. I've seen elderly people, they visit another family friend, and then they bedwet. That is the yoke of shame. Something that puts you to shame. Something that makes you to be on the front page to disgrace you is a yoke of the newspaper. You are the talk of the town. Something that puts shame in your life. Today, God will take shame from you and will replace shame with grace. When you destroy the yoke of shame, God will release grace on you. I pray today, every yoke of shame in your life shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Another yoke is the yoke of sin. You don't know how to control your emotion. You don't know how to control immorality, sin. You don't know how to control yourself, fornication, adultery, telling lies. It's a yoke of sin. Romans chapter 6 says, can we continue in sin and want the grace to abide? God forbid. I pray for you in Jesus' mighty name. That yoke of sin in your life is destroyed in Jesus' name. Romans chapter 6 verse 23 says, for the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. So there is a yoke of sin. Praise the Lord. When you get home, you can read these scriptures. John chapter 8 verse 34, Romans chapter 6 verse 18. Hallelujah. You can read it on your own, maybe in your offices and the rest. Praise the Lord. Then there's another yoke called the yoke of generational battles. The battles that your poor fathers have fought, they didn't win. Like an evil circle. Hallelujah. What happens to your parent is happening to you. Is a yoke. Today the Lord will destroy that generational yoke in Jesus' name. You see, in some family, the battle there is cancer. Their forefather died of cancer. The children's children are also dying of cancer. It's a battle. I pray for you today. That generational battle in your life shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. The yoke of stagnation. Another yoke that you must destroy. When your life is not moving, yoke will never move you forward. It will only stagnate your life. It will only stop you from moving forward. Every yoke of stagnation in your life today, I pray as a prophet, they are destroyed in Jesus' name. And you shall move forward in Jesus' mighty name. Another yoke is the yoke of bondage. The yoke of bondage. When your life is full of bondage, today God will set you free from every yoke of bondage in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. When you read the book of Galatians chapter 5, Galatians chapter 5, I pray anyone that is listening to me here, the yoke of bondage shall be destroyed in your life in Jesus' name. Praise God. Galatians chapter 5 verse 1. Stand fast therefore in the liberty wherein Christ has made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Hallelujah. The Lord will set you free from every yoke of bondage today in Jesus' mighty name. Yoke of bondage is a yoke, is a terrible yoke. Any kind of bondage, marital, God is going to destroy it today in Jesus' mighty name. The yoke of bad luck. When you are supposed to have good luck, you are receiving bad luck. The yoke of evil family pattern. The pattern that is in your family. Like in the family of Abraham, no firstborn exert. Hallelujah. Ishmael did not exert, but Isaac exert. Every pattern in your family yoke today is destroyed in Jesus' name by the anointing. You remember, Esau did not exert, but Jacob exert. Reuben, the firstborn, did not exert. Between Manasseh and Ephraim, the firstborn did not exert. There are yoke that is a pattern in your family. That yoke is destroyed by the anointing today in Jesus' name. There's a yoke of witchcraft. We call it the yoke of bewitchment, where people are bewitched by satanic forces. That yoke will be broken in your life today in Jesus' name. Then there is a yoke of backwardness. Instead of you to be going forward, your life is going backward, backward. Today the anointing will destroy it in Jesus' name. Then there is a yoke of polygamy. You are polygamous in your family. The Lord will break that yoke in Jesus' name. You cannot stay with one woman. I have seen a woman that had 7 husbands and 7 children. That's a yoke of polygamy. The Lord will break it in Jesus' name. Then the yoke of rebellion. You see people, they are rebellious. They don't respect authority. They don't respect their senior. They don't respect people in their office. They are very rebellious. It's a yoke. Then there's a yoke of rejection. When you are supposed to be accepted, they reject you. There's a yoke of character disorder, whereby somebody will just misbehave before his helper. Then there's a yoke of evil name. What is your name? Your name has something to do with your destiny. The Lord asked Abraham to change his name from Sarah to Sarah. So you have to change your name. God has the yoke of evil name in the life of Jacob. The meaning of Jacob is supplanter. The angel of the Lord, when he had an encounter with angel, the yoke was broken by the anointing, and then his name was turned to Israel. What is the name that you are bearing? Evil name. Today, God is going to cancel that yoke of evil name that you carry in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Evil marks in your body. We were told about Cain and Abel, that there was a mark that was put upon Cain. Is a yoke. I met a man, I had a story of a man who traveled from his village, and he went to abroad, and he felt that all is well. The demons and the attack has been gone in his life. But right there, there was a mark they put on him. And the mark brought him back to his country. Praise the Lord. Every evil mark, yoke in your life is destroyed. Yoke of idol worship. Maybe you worship idol. You worship anything that is not God. It's a yoke. The Lord will break it today in Jesus' name. Then we have the yoke of immorality. The yoke of alcoholism. Some people, they drink changa. It's a yoke. They cannot do without drinking alcohol. It's a yoke. Some cannot do without doing without not being involved in immorality. Then we have the yoke of evil foundation. The book of Psalm chapter 11 verse 3 tells us. It says, if the foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous do? I have an answer to that. The righteous will pray and use the anointing to break the yoke of evil foundation. Yoke of evil house. I have heard of a family that moved to a house and all their children died there. There are houses that have satanic yoke. The Lord will deliver you from that yoke of evil house in Jesus' name. Then we have the yoke of curses. The yoke of curses. In Genesis chapter 49, verse 3, there was a curse that was placed upon Reuben. And you can also read it in the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 5, verse 1. And in Deuteronomy 33, verse 1 to 16, the curse that was upon Reuben because he defiled his father's bed was broken by Moses in Deuteronomy 33, verse 1 to 16. Every curse that has been placed upon your life, according to the order, by the order of the curse that was placed upon Reuben in Genesis 49, verse 3 to 4, and 1 Chronicles chapter 5, verse 1. Today, that yoke of curses shall be broken in Jesus' name. And the Lord, when the anointing comes, because Moses is a man of the anointing, he started blessing. He released blessing upon Reuben. Anyone that is there that has been cursed, today you are free from that curse in Jesus' name. Then there's a marital yoke. When you cannot marry, you are single, no husband, no wife, God will break that yoke in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22 says, he that finds a good wife, finds a good thing, and obtain favor from the Lord. So if you are not married and you are of age, you are postponing and postponing is a yoke. The Lord will break that yoke in Jesus' name. There's another yoke of satanic delay. In the book of Daniel chapter 10, verse 13, the prayer that was supposed to be answered, it took 21 days. The prince of Persia delayed the prayer. Satanic delay. That delay in your life today shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Then there's a yoke of sickness. The book of Luke chapter 13, verse 10 to 13, talks about a woman who has been sick for 18 years. I don't know the kind of sickness that you have. Is it fibroid? Is it cancer? The Lord will break that yoke in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And the final yoke is the yoke of Christ. In the book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 to 30, Jesus said, my yoke is light. God wants you to, and that yoke is known as is a symbol of service for the Lord. I want to close by telling you today, beloved, that you can be free from that yoke. Only if you can give your life to Jesus Christ. When yokes are broken by the anointing, what will happen in your life are the following. Number one, the accused will be free. The blacklisted people will receive fame. The written all will be a centerpiece of history. You become a center. When yokes are broken by the anointing, these are the things that a victim will become a victor. Singles will become married. Borrowers will become lenders. Poor will become rich. Sick will become healthier. Beggars will become givers. non-entities will become celebrities. Backbenchers will become front runners. Sad people will become joyful. Forgotten will be remembered. Errant people will become masters. Hatred will become loved. Hallelujah. Fools will become wise. Disgrace will turn to honor. Rubbish people will be treasured. But before this can happen in your life, you must do one thing. You must accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. You must give your life to Jesus. That is when this yoke will be broken by the anointing. From what we read in the book of Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27. I want to pray for you now if you want to give your life to Jesus. Just say after me, say, Lord Jesus, write my name in the book of life. Wash me with your precious blood. Thank you for doing so in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you as you have given your life to Jesus Christ. And as you have given your life to Jesus Christ, you are a candidate of the people that will break the yoke by the anointing. Praise the Lord. You can worship in any living church around you. You can also fellowship with us in our church in Nairobi here, in Jogo Road, Eastland Cinema. We are located in Nairobi, Jogo Road, at the back of Uchumi Supermarket. We are at Eastland Cinema. Just ask for the Mountain of Fire and Miracle Ministries, and we pray for you. After you have given your life to Christ, you need deliverance. You need to pray a deliverance prayer. So you are welcome to our deliverance services, where the anointing will break and destroy your yoke. It shall come to pass on that day. Praise the Lord. Today is that day. I want to prophesy to your life right now that every yoke in your life, I don't want to know the kind of yoke. Let that yoke be broken. Let that yoke be destroyed now by the anointing in the name of Jesus. As Moses prayed for Reuben and the yokes were destroyed, I am praying by the unction of the anointing that God has given me in this commission. I break every yoke that is troubling your life in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. You can fellowship with us so that we can pray more together. Feel free to call me. Feel free to worship with us at our headquarters, and we shall break the yoke together by the anointing. God bless you. See you next time, and keep moving forward in life. Don't let evil yoke, don't let satanic yoke stop you. You are blessed. In Jesus' name, amen.